If you all would please help me welcome our very special guest, Ms. Sutton Foster! So I think we start right at the beginning. We want to know, what was the bug that bit you? How did you first start in theater?
I started dancing first. I was like a spazzy kid with a lot of energy and no coordination. And my mom thought it would be fun to put me into ballet class. So when I was 4, I started taking ballet. So I started dancing for fun. And then local community theater was doing a production of Annie when I was 10. And they were looking for orphans, so they called my dance studio. And I was like, what? What is this? Oh, it's a movie. Sure, I'll go on audition. And I got cast as Annie. And then it was all over. Well, I became obsessed.
Okay, now tell us, I know that a lot of the purpose of orphans, but tell us the early modern love story. How did it happen?
Do you guys know the show called Billy Modern
Melody? Yeah. Yeah.
So, I know. I got know. This was, I don't know, 12 years ago or so, and the before the show went to New York, it played out of town. It was in La Jolla, California, out in San Diego. And I was cast as the understudy for the role of Millie. And I was down there rehearsing, and about like a week before we went into tech rehearsals, the girl playing Millie got sick, and I stepped in for her as the understudy and rehearsed for her for like 3 or 4 days. And then at the end of that period, they ended up offering me the part. So I took over the role. I was the understudy who then became the lead. And I cried and kind of freaked out. And then I played the part in La Jolla, and then they asked me to take it to Broadway. So it was a crazy experience.
And now, how do you feel that your work ethic plays into the fact that you're one of the most desired actor Broadway actresses?
Well, I think it's important. I think work ethic is everything. I think people, if you are a hard worker, if you show up on time, if you do your work, if you are eager and available and open, people want to work with you. If you're a pain in the butt, if you're difficult, if you're late, if you don't know your stuff, if you're disinterested, people don't want to work with you. Why would you want to work with someone like that? So I feel like good work gets work. So my number one piece of advice to anyone starting out is don't be a jerk. Be open and available and respect your peers, your teachers, your parents, me, like everybody, but like be kind. Kindness goes a long way. And respect. Because, you know, if you want to make it in this business, it isn't about getting one job. It's about getting like 100 jobs. And because it's a business where it's constantly starting over, it's not like you're going to get a job and have it for 50 years unless you're in like Phantom or something. But it's, you want to give them reputation is huge. People, two talented people can walk into a room and audition, and if one has a negative reputation and they're of equal talent, or maybe the one with a negative reputation might be even more talented than the other one, I guarantee the people in the room are not going to want to work with that person. Why would you want to treat them differently?
Hi, I'm Eli Melvin, I'm 13, and I was wondering, when you get an audition, what are the things you do to prepare for it?
I hate auditioning. Auditioning's horrible, right? Anybody really like it? My number one piece of advice is to prepare. So say they want you to sing a song. Know the song. Sing something that you love. Don't use an audition as that opportunity to sing that song that's a little too high or the one that scares you to death. Like, sing a song you feel so solid about and that you're like, yes, I'm going to rock it. Because you're going to be nervous. So why go in there and sing something you like only sort of know? If they ask you to prepare a monologue, know that monologue inside and out. Make sure you have done it in front of people, not just alone in your room. Drag friends to your house, put them in a chair, and make them listen to you. And if they ask you to prepare a scene, make sure you have read that scene out loud at least 10 times with someone else, so that you are saying those words out loud and that you are making eye contact with the person you are talking to. It's stuff like that. So it's really about taking the time to practice. I'm not good at auditioning because I want to do all the work once I already have the job. I don't want to have to do all the work to get the job. Does that make sense? So it's kind of annoying, but if you want the job, you got to do the work.
If I have a fine white goose, I take it for a ride today. But since I have no fine white goose inside, I'll have to stay.
Do you wish for things?
Yes.
What do you wish for?
I wish that I was out of college, and I wish that I was in New York, and I was just free to just start my rotation in New York and audition and become you.
Does anybody else, do you guys wish for things? Who wishes for stuff? Oh, there we go. Mm-hmm. Why are you singing to all of us? That if I could, I would make all this happen, but I can't because I'm stuck at home.
If I had a fine white horse, I'd take you for a ride today. But since I have no fine white horse, inside I'll have to stay and empty all the chamber pots and scrub the floors and such. But what's there to do on a fine white horse? It seems to me not much.
It's good. It was really nice. I was watching you figuring it out. You're very smart. That's good stuff. Just keep going. It's a good song for you. Nice job.
Singing, I can do better than that in the last 5 years.
Okay.
My best friend had a little situation.
First, start the song. I'll just smile.
Okay. My best friend had a little.
Okay, start again. See, now you're smiling. You start the song, you're like, oh no, I'm a serious song. All right, start again. Good.
My best friend had a little situation at the end of our senior year.
Very quickly. You can take time. Like, actually, take, yeah, look.